ye shall receive power.
And ye shall receive what?
Power.
Power. Go ahead.
After that, the Holy Spirit is come unto you.
So it's like we read in John the first chapter. To as many as receive Hamashiach Yahushua, receive his word, receive his truth, right? To them gave the Most High, to them Most High gave them power. Alright, gave them the Holy Spirit. Alright? Go ahead.
And ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem, and in all Judea, and in all Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth.
So what was the power that the disciples was given? It was given power for miracles, to perform miracles, cast out demons out of people. See what I'm saying? And we have that power today through the Holy Spirit. When we're out there, it's not to the point where, you know, physically where they did, but only thing a false doctrine or somebody that's, you know, crazy, all that is unclean spirits within them. See what I'm saying? So like it tells you in Corinthians, we bring all through this knowledge, through the truth, you know, which comes through the Holy Spirit, we have the power to remove unclean spirits from people through this word, through using the word. See what I'm saying? Now you are clean through the word which I spoken unto you. So we still have that power even today. Alright? Read that verse 8 again, or read the top again.
Verse 8. But ye shall receive power. After that the Holy Spirit is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem, and in all Judea, and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost parts of the earth.
Right, so, and that's what we're doing right now. We're witnesses. How are we witnesses of the Most High in Christ? Because we know this word. You have to have seen something or heard something to be a witness. So we're witnesses of the Most High in Christ because we know we understand this truth. Keep the law, statutes, and commandments. We've learned, we cleaned ourselves up. The Holy Spirit has come upon us, and that's what enables us to be witnesses of this word, of this truth. That's why we go out and we teach this word. Why? Because we know it. We've learned it, we've studied it, we're living it. That's what makes us witnesses unto all of us. That's what makes us witnesses unto the Most High in Christ. And that's what Christ told them in at this time, at the day of Pentecost. All right, so jump over. Yeah. Oh, no. I thought you said you had something. Okay. So let's go to Acts 2nd chapter. Go to Acts 2 verse 1. So we're talking about when Hamashiach promised that he would send the Comforter amongst the Jews, the Israelites, his disciples, right? Which was the power, the Holy Spirit. All right, so let's read when that happened. Acts chapter 2, starting verse 1.
Acts 2 and 1. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting.
Right, so again, Penta means 50. All right, so this is a celebration, Feast of Weeks, Pentecost. They were all the Israelites, all the Jews came from every land, as we're going to read down, for this feast day. All right, so go ahead.
And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it set upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak with other tongues, as the Spirit gave them utterance. And there were dwelling at, and there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men, out of every nation under heaven.
Right, so what people were there? Jews, Israelites. Where did they come from? They came out of every nation under heaven. All right, to celebrate this feast day. It was Jews out of every nation of under heaven. Jews, and there were of the, there was you had northern kingdom there too. You had a lot of the northern kingdom Israelites were there, came on this feast day also. Because I think in Tobit, it spoke about how Tobit was, it was Tobit, how he went to was it the feast of, was it the first fruits, or was it the
Tobit the second chapter?
Yeah, that's the Tobit the second chapter. So, and he had he brought a lot of the northern kingdom, the tribes, and not Calvin. So he had a lot of the northern kingdom Israelites that after the separation of the nation of Israel, he had the northern and the southern kingdom. Most of the northern kingdom, you know, they didn't come to Jerusalem anymore. They started keeping their own feast days, keeping them on the wrong days, keeping them up, you know, outside of Jerusalem where the Most High said his name. And but you also had some that came back and would come back every year and during the Passovers and Feast of Weeks from the northern kingdom. Right? So it was Israelites out of every nation under heaven came to this high holy day. Go ahead.
Now when this was noise abroad, the multitude came together and were confounded, because that every man heard them speak in his own language. And they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, "Behold, are not all these which speak Galileans?"
Right, because the Galileans, up there in Galilee, they spoke Hebrew. Right? So he said, are not all these which speak Galileans? Go ahead.
And how hear we every man in our own tongue wherein we were born?
So you had Jews and Israelites coming from different lands, speaking different languages, which was at the same time, which was being understood. See what I'm saying? It was being understood by everyone there. All right, through the power of the Most High. Go ahead.
Corinthians and Medes and the Elamites and the dwellers in Mesopotamia and in Judea and Cappadocia and Pontus and Asia and Phrygia and Pamphylia and Egypt and in the parts of Libya about Cyrene, and strangers of Rome, Jews and proselytes.
Right, Libya, you got Egypt, you got a lot of African places there. Libya, Cyrene, Egypt, yeah, Israelites all up in Africa. Northern Africa. Go ahead.
Remember you had Simon.
Come.
Greeks and Arabians, we do hear them speak in our tongues the wonderful works of the Most High of Mashiach Yahushua.
And notice, read that last verse again.
Verse 10.
Creeks in Arabia.
He said, Creeks in Arabia. All right, but that wasn't Arabs. That was Israelites living in Arabia. So sometimes when the Bible says a name of a nation, it could actually be talking about an Israelite from that nation. All right, like when Paul wrote to the Romans, he wrote to the saints that was in Rome, he wrote to the Israelites that was in Rome. So you have to be careful and understand the context that it's saying is in the center. That wasn't Arabs like you see on the corner store today in New York, right? Those were the Israelites that was living in Arabia. All right, because we were scattered. Listen, when the Most High said he was going to scatter us, that's what he meant. He removed us into every kingdom on the earth. So these are all Israelites, but it's calling them by the lands that they live in. Like we call them Americans now. Right, but when Israelites living in America. So you gotta get the context of what verse, you know, what verses is speaking about an Israelite from that land or an actual heathen from that land. All right, go ahead.
Let me get Romans 8:23.
Everybody taking your notes down? Good? Go back over them, you know, if you got some free time tomorrow or whatever. You should, because it's a feast day. You know, go back over these notes tomorrow.